Hopkins, welcome back to this week's show.
Today we have sports, man on the street, entertainment, ASB updates, announcements, and more.
That's right.
And Falcon TV starts right now.
5, 4, 3, 2. Did you know the Padres won the wild card series?
Yeah, I saw the games, of course.
Let's see what else is new in sports with Rohan and Maddie.
Hello, Falcons. Welcome back to the sports update.
We have some exciting new matches coming up this week.
Starting with the NFL.
On Sunday, the Jaguars are playing the Bears, the Buccaneers are facing the Saints, Commanders are up against the Ravens, and the Cardinals are playing the Packers.
Don't forget the Colts and Titans are up against each other, and the Texans and Patriots are going to.
I'm looking forward to watching those games.
Me too, let's get some NBA action.
We have the 76ers and the Celtics matchup, the Grizzlies and the Bulls, the Jazz and the Spurs,
the Pelicans and Heat, Timberwolves and Knicks, and lastly, the Trailblazers and Kings.
Those are a lot of matches. I'm looking forward to seeing the results.
Let's get to the MLB playoff games.
We have the Padres and Dodgers in a tight matchup, the Phillies and the Nationals go head-to-head, and many more.
That's it for this week, Falcon.
Now back to the anchors.
Thanks, Ron and Maddie. I'm excited for the upcoming games.
Me too.
I'm also excited for the new movies coming out. I heard there's a lot.
Actually.
Anyways, let's go to entertainment with Addie and Nico.
Hello, Falcons.
Welcome back to entertainment.
Oh, have you seen that Moana 2 is coming out? I remember watching the first movie when I was a little kid.
That sounds like a good movie. Also, Sonic the Hedgehog 3 and Mufasa the Lion King are coming out December 20th.
I can't wait for those movies. Now, moving on to books, a new Dogman book by Dave Pilkey is coming out December 3rd, and a new Hunger Games book, too.
Those sound interesting. I've read all the Hunger Games books. I'm excited for a new one.
Yeah, me too. But I have wanted to listen to more music lately. Is there anything new yet?
Some new top trending songs right now are Die With a Smile by Lady Gaga, featuring Bruno Mars, and Hot to Go by Chavo Rum.
I've heard those songs have been all over the internet lately. Anyway, that's it for entertainment, Falcons. Now back to the anchors.
Thanks, Addie and Nika.
Now I know what to watch this week.
Me too. Sam, would you rather own a cat or a dog?
Cats are good, but dogs, obviously.
I agree. Let's go to Man on the Street with Layla Anderson to see what the other Falcons have to say.
Hi, Falcons. Today we're going to be doing Man on the Street and asking, would you rather dress in the 2000s fashion or the 80s fashion, and why? Would you rather dress in the 80s fashion or the 2000s fashion, and why?
2000s fashion, because it's better than the 80s. Or 1800s, or whatever you said.
Okay, thank you. Would you rather dress in the 80s fashion or the 2000s fashion, and why?
I would rather dress in the 2000s fashion because it's more recent to how we dress now.
Okay, thank you. Would you rather dress in the 80s fashion or the 2000s fashion, and why?
80s fashion.
And why?
Because it's old.
Okay, thank you. Would you rather dress in the 80s fashion or the 2000s fashion, and why?
Probably the 2000s, because people have weird hair in the 80s.
Probably the 2000s, because, I don't know, just because.
You wanna come.
Okay, thank you. Would you rather dress in the 80s fashion or the 2000s fashion, and why?
Probably the 2000s, because I'm pretty sure gingers didn't exist back in the 1980s, so.
Probably the 2000s, because it's just better clothes.
Probably the 1700s, because they had a bunch of armor back then, too.
Big back.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Would you rather dress in the 80s fashion or the 2000s fashion, and why?
Probably 2000s, because it has better fashion sense.
2000s, because I like it better.
2000s, because I like how they dress.
Okay, thank you. Those are some pretty cool answers, Falcons. Personally, I would dress in the 2000s fashion. Now back to the anchors.
Thanks, Layla.
With all this talking, I'm getting kind of hungry.
Me too. Oh, did you hear about Addie's news story called A Taste of Heaven?
No, I haven't.
Let's go check it out.
There are many places to get your sweet treats, such as Menchie's, Handel's, Dirty Dough, and Get and Go. But there's one place that stands out from the rest. With their new outstanding flavors each week, Crumble Cookie rises to the top.
I'm a baker, so bake cookies, serve them. It's super tight-knit. I mean, I've been working here for 2 years, so we're all really close. We have to be like super collaborative, telling each other like what we need done, but in a very like nice way, just so we all work together and get things done. So I'd say later at night, so starting right now, what time is it, like 5? So at 5 o'clock it starts getting busy, and we normally stay busy until 10 or midnight. So yeah, we just serve a lot of sweet treats, and I feel like a lot of people come here when, I don't know, they're having like a bad day or are looking to celebrate something. So it's always nice when people come here like in a happier mood or in a better mood. So
I'm the fill position, so whatever people that come in, the customers, either for DoorDash or the call-ins or anything, pretty much I'm fulfilling every order that comes into our system. This week, honestly, I would say it's a tie, probably between the maple and tough one. Probably say the raspberry one. Probably Mondays, because that's when like the fresh cookies drop, so everybody's trying to get like their takes in. Like, some people are food reviewers too, so you know, you gotta get reviews in, you know.
As you can see, Crumble Cookie provides mouthwatering desserts, from their churro flavor to their chocolate chunk. With the creativity they put in every treat, this local cookie shop gives happiness to their community. With camera operator Sam Hemrick, this is Addison Cook reporting for Falcon TV.
Thanks, Addie, that was good.
Now I want a cookie. I should be one for Halloween.
Yeah, you should. I'm so excited about Halloween this year.
Probably not as excited as me.
Are you going to the Haunted Corn Maze?
I don't know, should I?
Yeah, definitely.
Are there any other cool events like the Corn Maze happening?
I don't know. Let's see Reed for more announcements.
Hello, Falcons. Welcome back to your weekly announcements. Some fun events are coming up this month. For example, on the 31st, you can wear your Halloween costume at school. However, make sure your costume is school appropriate. Also, no full face masks. The 21st to the 25th is Red Ribbon Week. You'll be able to dress up in things that represent the daily prompt throughout the week. On the 16th, dress in orange for Unity Day. Also, tell your parents about the parent-teacher conferences from the 14th to the 16th. Mark your calendars for the 15th for Blaze Pizza Night in the Carlsbad Outlet from 4 to 8 p.m. Hopefully, we see you there. There is a band fundraiser on October 12th at Applebee's in Oceanside from 8 to 10 a.m. We'd love to see you there. Well, that's all for this week's announcements, Falcons. Now let's go to Maddie with the ASB update.
Hi, Falcons. Welcome back to your weekly ASB updates. I'm here with
Mattis Ferdinas
and Ellie Carr. What do we have today?
We have the pumpkin decorating contest happening right now from the 1st to the 25th. And also from the 7th to the 18th, we have boot camps for sale.
What are some more fun and exciting things happening soon?
Like Reed said, we have Blazing Pizza Night at the Carlsbad Outlets from 4 to 8 p.m., so make sure to get yourself something delicious to eat. Also, if your birthday is in October, I hope you grab your sweet treat at brunch. We also have Padres Spirit Day yesterday, so I hope you wore your Padres gear.
Anything else?
Another event happening this month is Red Ribbon Week. It is happening through the 21st to the 25th, so make sure to dress up on Spirit Days for candy. Lastly, on Halloween, there will be music and activities at brunch. Make sure to wear your costume, too. And make sure that it's school appropriate.
That's it for ASB updates. Thank you. Now back to the anchors.
Thanks, Maddie and Reed.
That was great.
Are there any other news stories that are so fun to watch?
Yeah, let's get a Noah's news story on the camp store.
There are plenty of places to relax, eat food, and enjoy the beach views, like Chandler's, Poseidon, and Vigi Luigi's. There is one place that is a local gem called the Camp Store. The Camp Store is known for having an amazing food with even better community.
The Camp Store originated when Anthony decided to take over this building that was not being used anymore and create a place that live music can happen, turn it into a pizza place, a fun place. Basically, you can come watch the sunset and where you can ride your bike on over and meet your friends.
The reason I came to the Camp Store is because the atmosphere is great, the food here is really good, and just the view here is really nice. Being able to see the waves is awesome.
Top selling item here at the Camp Store is our handmade pizza. We make all of our dough from scratch. All the ingredients are made with love, and then it's put into a wood-fired oven, and out comes the magic. We have live music. Right now it's Wednesday through Sunday, and we are also showcasing our holiday light show, and that goes on from 6:30 to about 8 o'clock every night. And then we'll be having our Christmas light show as well, starting in December.
As you can see, the camp store is a great place to meet new people, have great food, and have great views. With camera operator Nico Smith, this is Noah Lecklider reporting for Falcon TV.
Thanks, Noah.
I'm so excited about the weekend.
Me too.
Well, that's it for this week's Falcons.
We'll see you next time on Falcon TV.